But seems like only yesterday we were here for Super Bowl 52, and now back for the road to the Super Bowl here in the Twin Cities at U.S. Bank Stadium. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Green Bay Packers and the Minnesota Vikings. One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. Fielded near the back of the end zone.
So much for the best laid plans and best designed plays. That was good coverage along the sidelines. No place for that one to get in there. It sails incomplete.
Leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Single. Hey, guys.
From the gun, it's Tua. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. It's caught at the 25. And he finally goes down the night before reaching the 21. Setting the throw on first down is Tua. On right side here, and that's complete. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant, a lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, he often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule.
Drop deep. Watch the edge.
And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. They got two of the three they needed there. Leaves him with third and just a yard.
That's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Packers bringing in an extra member of the secondary here to try for the third down stop. Here's Cook. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Taking it in from 11 yards out. And the Vikings take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator? Remember what he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Fielded in the end zone. And he'll just sit the on this one as the drive will start at the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
Take a shot right away into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 18, and he'll bring it all the way back just a yard or two shy of midfield. What a start defensively. defensively, your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. And they took the shot downfield. They were more than prepared for that one.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
33, yellow.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
They'll wind up getting four down to the 36.
Number 33, Dalvin Cook.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to that'll feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
31's the mic. Hey. 31's the mic.
Drill green.
Coming. Oh, yeah, I'm coming. 31's the mic.
Let them know.
31's the mic.
That's right, baby. They don't want it.
Cut. Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. Escaping the pressure right. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Jason Alexander. And he'll bring this one back to the 29. When he went on the move there and started rolling out, I thought there was a window, but that window closed quickly, intercepted.
And sometimes, despite how big your arm talent is, you don't get enough on a throw when you're on the move as opposed to setting your feet and stepping into one. That may have been the case there, and the defense certainly benefited.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They had the interception last time and led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
It's a pickup of three.
They did a really nice job there defensively. They strung the play out. Didn't give him a cutback lane. On each play, you have guys what I call our BCR players. Guys are responsible for the bootleg, for the cutback, and for the reverse.
Hey,
they played
the
that one perfectly.
And rode him right out of
Mike
bounds.
22, he's coming, 22. Mike. You can't block me. You can't block me.
No. On second and 7, Allen. Oh, hit as he throws there. Incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball. But surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
7 yards to go.
Head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on second down.
43 is the mic. 43 is the mic.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. Now that'll be tipped and intercepted.
That's how you get fouled.
Tipped by Jack Lamb. Into the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at the 43-yard line.
Ready. 60 red. 60 red.
31's the mic.
Black shot.
31's the mic.
Hey, man.
After the turnover, it's Tua. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And into the end zone. It's
touchdown,
a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
I'm coming.
And we'll see if that pick six looms large as this game continues, because we've seen plays like that alter a lot of process over the years.
I would agree with that totally, and you often think to yourself, why do they alter it so much? Because after games, don't we hear coaches and players say, well, one play doesn't usually determine the outcome? But I don't think that's really true, do you? Because there's times when we see plays like that, and all of a sudden the momentum jumps to that team side, it deflates the other side, and they never pick it back up. And then things really go from there.
That's the thing for me. We talk about momentum changes. A play like that is the ultimate momentum change. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And following the pick six, decent field position of throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guys, listen, just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance.
On second down, this one up to the 35-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off. Because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
No. Off.
Steal. Black.
To the 41. They get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and are controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards, but also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
Last run got six. Now second and four.
Stop your whining.
Spike, wait.
Tight end Irv Smith Jr. He'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
Week definitely helps come playoff time.
Ready.
And those were some fresh legs right there. That extra practice time and planning, certainly in evidence.
Two are going to throw. Complete. Jefferson the target. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple. And it's second down.
The Packers, 18-yard line.
Yellow. 10 black.
31's the mic. Hey, watch the slant.
Again, they will throw it with Tagovailoa. Flushed out right. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Dalvin Cook with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Vikings have taken the lead. And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And this carries into the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Five wide.
Mike 22, he's counting
22. Back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he takes it all the way down to the 32.
Josh Allen in quarterback.
It's a big play there for Green Bay. 43 yards.
43 yards. First down, Green Bay.
Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score.
Vikings, 14. Packers, 7.
Here we go. Hey, tight,
that first down completion only netted him. And some room to work. And he'll have it in the front zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 12 yards there and a first down.
And a Packer.
We really didn't have any doubt that he was going to be one of the top-rated rookies coming into the league, especially as a runner. And he's given us no reason to change our minds. That's a big-time run, and the production that he showed us in college is translating very well into the National Football League.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. That's complete, right around the 8. And the Packers are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. 10 more there and another first down. Take it in. Touchdown, 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this game. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat and the driver will get at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. You've almost got to get down to a starter's box like you're expecting. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get to the face of the pass.
Easier said than done, though.
Easier said than done, but they got to try something because right now they're just cutting the shorts.
He's going to air one out. That's caught inside the 20. And he takes it down deep into Green Bay territory. A big play there for Minnesota. 25 yards. And the ball is out. And the Packers pick it up. One back to the 36-yard line. The defense, they were swarming that time and ultimately got to him before he could get rid of the football and knocked it free.
And don't you feel just a little bit of sympathy for him back there, though? So much going on. So much swarming around. He's trying to find someone downfield. He's trying to move around and find an open target. Sometimes you forget the number one thing. Take care of the football.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
A gain of five.
Nice satisfying run up first down for the offense, picking up five, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we got to tighten this
and forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. That second down play, that's a minus four. Out to his left. He may try and run for this. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. Gain of nine that time on the scramble. 1 yard shy of the marker, and it brings up fourth.
But it brings up fourth down.
And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on fourth and a yard.
22's coming, Mike.
I got it.
Mike 22. Rip right.
They do go for it. Here's Allen. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Danielle Hunter and the Vikings, they have the football now in excellent field position. Tua. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Now Tua. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
They face a third and four after that last completion gets them six.
Mike,
Go pink.
My 30.
Red. Cycle.
No gain on this defense. No gain.
Just look at the playoff as he'll look to throw. And he's got Vikings first down by about a yard. It's a gain of 5 on 3rd and 4. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, but it's good for a first down as well.
Ready, down, yellow, 22.
Watch your left, because I'm about to take you to school.
Needle blue.
My 36.
Hey, get in the weight room. Watch 30.
Ready, go.
2 and a throw again. Eluding the pressure right. And this is incomplete.
Tungo by Loa.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
36 to Mike.
Check pass. Mike 36.
Watch the pass.
Two and a try again on second down. Escaping the pressure right. And this is caught at the 8.
That's good.
And he is out of bounds. But first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. A good pickup there at 22.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend.
Go!
We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman. Standing by. Eventful divisional round weekend. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Can't afford another delay here as they come up again on second and goal.
Claws red.
Mike 22.
Looking to pass. Tua. Now the pressure gets there and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack. But he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football. Had to eat it and ended up on the ground.
95. A big one coming in this division round playoff. Third and goal. He's got it. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Fourth and goal.
Field goal would break the tie, but look at this. Instead, they're going to go for it on fourth and goal. Tagovailoa going for it on fourth down. And Rudolph has got it. The big tight end for a Viking touchdown. A 3-yard touchdown pass. And the Vikings are going to take the lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run.
this fair one catch. As a fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time out, Turnadol gave a great field position, turned into 6 points. They've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused every bit of it,
but a
shred of
confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also, shred confidence in the defense. They're into the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Touchdown, Packers!
Pass. A big play to number 82.
With his second touchdown here in this first half.
The kicker on.
And the Packers have been an extra point of tying this thing up.
His kick
and that is
going
to tie our game as we approach
that
halftime.
That ties the game at 21 apiece.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled
fair
for
catch
and taken
the
successfully.
Yard line. The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And we're under a minute to go here. What's been an even first half all tied up?
Yeah, still time to make something happen, too. Couple completions, just string them together. Could get into field goal range. Let's see what happens.
He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. That'll bring up second down.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Complete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
Watch the pass.
Here's Tagovailoa to throw. Trying to lay one up deep. Oh, and Tua going to be intercepted for the third time. Picked off by Darnell Savage.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively. And you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
Hey, that QB's trash. Let's go. Switch. Hey, watch the edge.
Check. Well, indeed, trying to run it as they start on the ground. And defensively, they're just
number
looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down.
He's brought down.
Now the Packers
going to
go ahead and use
line.
The second of their timeouts.
A 6-yard pickup.
As they get it right at the 30-second mark of this first half.
43 is the mic, boy.
Alert!
Check, 43. I got you.
Action. Now it's Allen. Push to his right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Now the Vikings will use the second of their timeouts. As the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime.
319.
Third down. Third and 13.
Mike, 40.
Off 52.
On third and long, it's Allen. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. The Vikings going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. On fourth down, J.K. Scott ready to punt it away. And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. So out of bounds on the punt, and the spot will be, the side judge says, right at the 35-yard line
at
here.
At their own 35-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Buying time to his left. And he's going to keep it here. Second and four. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC Divisional Round matchup. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, a trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. Hit a wall, so to speak.
Have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defenses right now, they seem to be a step ahead.
And Allen going to be intercepted for the third down. William Jackson with a pick. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Not the way you envision things to start out the third quarter. One play and already a turnover.
It's interesting. You and I were talking with the coach, and he talked about how at halftime, as a play caller, he wanted to make sure he got a new script going for the second half, not just the one that he operated off of to start the game. Nowhere on that script did it have that result.
Well-executed 22-yard game.
First
and the Vikings are going to have it first and goal as he'll take this down to about the three.
Brandon went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line. Because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
On the ground, yes. And he'll get in. Touchdown. And the Vikings capitalize on the short field. And it's good. That makes it a 28-21 game.
Makes this score Vikings 28, Packers 21.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Ready to get their next drive underway. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go to the end on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Allen's pass.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Allen going to throw. Being chased out left. Looking deep for Adams. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception.
Allen's pass.
Picked off inside the 10. Not the best of plays there as a quarterback. You're right-handed, rolling left, trying to throw it that far downfield.
I remember a coach of mine saying, son, that's the equivalent of trying to get the car keys out of your pocket with your opposite hand while you're doing it.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
Oh, yeah.
Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Back at his own 4-yard line.
Here we go. Set. Blue. 32.
36. You ain't going nowhere.
Going to the air. Tagovailoa. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete. Tagovailoa trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
All right, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. Third and long coming up. Back near your own goal line, I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for them. You got to try and find some space for your punter because you don't want him backed up where he has to alter what he does.
22. Not here. Watch 36. 36 to Mike. Watch the run. Mike, 36.
On third and long, it's Tagovailoa. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off at the 14. That into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
We constantly talk about defenders having great vision and being able to see and make some plays, but you also have to have good feel as well, because you can't see everything out there. See the play unfold, feel what's going on, and then get into the right spot and make your own play. And in this case, it turned out to be a highlight one.
So right back to square one, tied at 28 as he kicks it away.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway.
Black shot.
Tagovailoa trying again after the pick six. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down.
First and 10 at the 45-yard line.
60 red.
You got nothing.
From the gun, it's Tua. And my goodness, another interception. He's picked off near his own.
They should have put a stamp on me in the locker room, because I just delivered.
To the end zone. It's a pick six. Touchdown. A big play there by the rookie. An interception followed by the return for 6 points.
If you want to be accepted by your teammates and coaching staff, make plays like that.
The kick is good.
And it's up and good.
Makes the score Packers 35. Vikings.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Now this will make it into the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. And the same result, and he opted for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are stuttering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to pull your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily changing your plays. Oh, this hurts the defense. I want to put it in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
Mike 22. Come on.
Throwing now is Tagovailoa. He's got it at the 15. Inside the 15-yard line. He got 29 yards that time.
First and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Is a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Watch tight. Tight ends right. Watch tight.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
On the keeper.
Another throw there off the mark. And obviously he's battled all of the interceptions. Things just haven't been true to form for him. I don't know. What do you think's going on out there, CD?
That's a great question. And my suspicion is he's been coached really well to not show that he's having a problem. You know, they always tell you, no matter what, you keep throwing the football with confidence. Well, we're not seeing a confident thrower right now. He's off balance, the passing game is off balance, and the defense is taking advantage.
It's complete. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line.
Nine
yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Came up a little short on the last pass play. They did get 9 yards out of it, leaving him with his third and one. They'll try and get him down. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the one. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal. First and goal. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. A great play there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Vikings are going to win for tying this thing up.
fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Offense ready to get their next drive underway, and their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete, and he gets this one just shy of the 40. Down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14. Room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41.
Taken down.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Brings up second and 9.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose runner pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that play. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. A full 5-yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough.
Sometimes I think cornerbacks can benefit from the fact that quarterbacks might just forget about the idea that they might be near the line of scrimmage. How about the anticipation there, sneaking in and making a big play in the backfield?
So now they operate back from their side of the field here, second and long.
43 is the mic. Watch me go.
So the shotgun snap to Allen. Throwing right, and that's complete. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. On third down. Dancing to his left. And he'll get this to the 40, but that's still going to be a few yards short of the first down. It'll be a gain of 8, but it also lead to a fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Too long for a field goal, too short to punt that in-between range. And I don't think he got there. He did not. They stopped him a yard shy. He needed two. He only got one. And the Vikings defense is going to get the football back. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the run game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing. I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. On first down, this is Geis. Takes this for about 6.
Number
down
29,
inside the
40. Darius Geis, the ball carrier.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and 4. Here's Tua. And he works it to the 30-yard line here right at the 30. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from a defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Tagovailoa working out of the gun. This was brought in by Jefferson. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
To Justin Jefferson.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brings up second and 5 at the 25-yard line.
Tua gonna throw. Polluting the pressure right. And that'll be incomplete.
I like that right there. Not only was it the right throw, throwing it away like that.
Brings up
frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
The Vikings on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 4 of 5. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into the wall. Scrimmage. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
No gain on the play. It's fourth down.
The kick by Bass is good. And the Vikings have a 3-0 lead. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it, happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown
at their own
and seal this thing?
Yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And this could be the defining moment of their season. All hyperbole aside, you're trailing here in the fourth quarter of the divisional round. They need to come up with something as they get this drive started. Stepping up, he'll try and run. He'll get
Allen
8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Round
there's
80.
A second and 2 now from the 33.
Second and 2 at the 33-yard line.
Middle. And we heavy on the edges,
Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. And Allen goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
The defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
The Packers on third down. Not going over 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's 4th down.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to have the 1st down at about the 38. They've been burned twice already on 4th down, but the 3rd time's the charm as they run with Coleman on 1st down.
Watch the twist. Watch the twist. Watch the shift. Watch the shift. Watch the shift. Watch the shift.
And finally out of bounds, just a few yards short of the goal line at the 3. It's a big play that time for the Packers. 59 yards for him on the ground. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on 1st down. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop it right at the 1. 2nd and goal from the 1.
A pickup.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Down at goal from the 1.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play. 3rd and goal. And he gets halfway there down to the 1-yard line. They needed 2. He only got 1 on the sneak, and that's going to lead us to a 4th and 1. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker. And a big smile. That's an extra point attempt here. This is an 18-yarder. I tell you, the life of a kicker. He has not been called on the entire game. He's over there by the net, but they send him out here in the 4th quarter and say, hey, go tie the game, will you? And guess what? He comes through.
I just don't know how they do it. I really don't. These cats are a different breed from you and me. That's a pressure kick, but that one was never in doubt.
The Vikings take over 1st and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And as a fan of the NFL, not much more you could hope for in this divisional round matchup. Tie game, fourth quarter. A lot of these fans with their hearts in their throats waiting to see. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander.
Well, all I can do up here is just shake my head. Six interceptions. I cannot imagine what he's thinking between the ears right now.
But just think of how it is for his teammates, because after the first few, you know they're going over to him, hey, we'll get him next time. Now they're probably a little bit frustrated. And if you're a receiver, you're thinking to yourself, any ball that's
alert,
in the air,
alert, alert.
You become receiver. You've got to go compete for the ball so you don't get another one picked off.
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. It'll be a loss of seven on the play. And it'll be a second and long.
56, 56.
Like 22, he's coming, 22's coming.
From the gun, it's Allen. He's got his man on the crossing route.
Allen's pass. Complete.
It's a number 86. 12, and that'll set up a third down.
A 12-yard gain on the play.
And it's got a third down. He finds a man on the crossing route. And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
A game
great
of
way to convert
yards.
On third down there. 21
down,
yards the play.
Packers.
Getting down to the good stuff.
Go,
all tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. Already. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. And now right out of the 2 minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Regular.
Get the
ball right here. Let's go.
Mike
22.
Let's go. Back to throw. Allen. His throw caught at about the five. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. From 19 yards away. And the Packers have moved out in front.
The
still an important piece of business
after.
To take care of, the extra point. And they will take a seven-point lead now.
Good. Makes the score Packers 45, Vikings 38.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken in the end zone.
The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling.
He can't get a throw away. He's taken down. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go.
Go red.
22, he's coming. 22's coming. Mike.
Check. Ready.
They'll look to throw. And he can't corral it. That one ramped it up. If he's been able to hold it, instead it brings up third down.
Incomplete.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit him over the top with the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
Mike. Watch the slants.
Mike 22. Let's go, baby. Need turnovers. Get that ball.
Claws red.
Mike 22, he's coming. 22's coming. Mike.
Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go.
Blue, go. Smash, red.
Back to throw is Tua. He's got his man on the crossing route. He's into the end zone. So late score they needed. And Alley extra point can tie this thing up in the final minute.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
Bass on for the extra point. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Takes this about 5 yards deep.
And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25.
Offense ready to get their next drive underway. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all the sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it inside or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. As the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Mike 53.
Now Allen. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and forced an incompletion.
Check. Half. Check. 53's Mike. He can't hang.
Escaping the pressure right. And now he's going to use his legs. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
It's a gain of 8.
He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down.
Round 80!
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone.
5 wide.
Let's go, defenses. Get out the field, defense.
Allen to throw. Going down. It's complete. And he's going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
It's a gain.
Now the Packers
going to
go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in this football game. So first and 10 now from the 30. A bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
On running plays, linemen, of course, have their assignments. That's expected. But it's not often you're expecting to see a quarterback blitzing in run support and tackling the runner for a loss.
And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. So this is certainly a tough test here in the early career of the rookie kicker. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left. So this is certainly a tough test here in the early career of the rookie kicker. The second in the NFC title game. And he got it.
The field goal
the
is good.
The kick is good. He splits the uprights.
Makes the
and
score.
In doing
Packers
so, he sends him to the NFC
Vikings
title game.
45.
The Packers are moving on as we say thanks for watching and so long. So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out